keep on punishing me?
Some folk won't let go, Reese, and they've got nothing better to do than to poke their noses into other people's business. There's nothing you can do about it, son.
I'm doing a good job. I'm working hard. I swear, Mrs. Graves thinks I'll start nicking stuff if she turns about for a second.
Liz is all right. She's one of the good ones.
Yeah, well, she's not exactly honest with her husband about what she gets up to.
None of that. You're angry about people judging you. Don't be so fast to judge others.
I'm sorry, Frank.
Keep your gob shut, your nose clean, and your head down. Do you think you can manage that?
Gob, nose, head. Got it.
And steer clear of that Rachel girl. If I've seen you two making eyes at each other, then so's her dad. And you don't want Sam Baker coming round after you. Now, pass me that socket spanner and we'll see if we can get this wheel back on.
Can you see the observatory from there?
That's over the ridge, just past the windmill. You want to live near the station in case you need a quick getaway?
Something like that. So you and Stephen, I'm sensing there's not a lot of love lost there, huh?
That's between him, me, and the cows.
You're gonna have to explain that one for me.
It's nobody else's business. Look, you seem all right to me. You don't want to worry about that lot in the village.
Provided I'm left alone, I'm happy. Stephen's the one who likes to be at the center of things.
No change there, then.
Francis Appleton. You are a bad man. No wonder your sister won't talk to you.
Thank you.
Breaker, Breaker 9, calling on 9. This is Lost Cowboy looking for anyone out there. Hello? Breaker 1-9. Breaker traveling Sherlock. Charlie, you out there? Over.
Hello? My wife and kids.
Yeah, I'm perfectly well. What you've got to do.
I can't do it. Don't ask me to do it. You're asking me to sign their death warrant. My own family.
Abbott, don't you think I'm aware of that? I'll still be here when you drop the fucking stuff.
No.
Don't you lecture me about sacrifice,
you stupid bastard!
You're so full of ideas, you come here and try dealing with it. Tell them the time when we had a choice is over. Tell them to do it. You've got to do it now.
Just seems a bit odd, that's all. She's just over the hill. Why can't we go and collect her?
You heard the radio. Try to minimize contact with different groups of people. Might be spreading that way. Besides, Father Jeremy told me that Lizzie Graves said they're all fine. They're still planning on putting on their show.
So how does Father Jeremy know what's going on at the camp if we're all supposed to be staying at home?
A special dispensation for the clergy or something. I'm sure Rachel will be all right. She seems to live at the camp these days anyway.
She's 16, Sam. It's going to happen. I was pregnant when I was 17.
Yeah, well, that's why I'm worried about what Rachel gets up to. Come on, give me that other case. We'll still be here at midnight if we don't get a bloody move on.
Can't understand why the car wouldn't start. We'll have to get someone out to take a look at it.
What about the station?
That's shut down too. So there's no way in or out of the valley. They're obviously serious about this flu thing.
Phil doesn't think it's flu at all. He said he's been practicing medicine for 30 years and he's seen plenty of flu, and he said this doesn't feel right at all.
Well, there's nothing of any use on the radio.
Sorry, I'm late, everyone. Have you started?
Yes, but to be honest, there's not really that much to discuss. This quarantine is in place. There's roadblocks and everything. No one really seems to know anything, but people are definitely missing. More of them too, not just a couple of old biddies. No one's seen the Sullivans since yesterday, and the house is just sitting there unlocked.
I just got back from the farm. All of Frank's cows died in the night. He's devastated.
Poor man. Hasn't he had enough for one year? First Mary and now this.
Well, if no one's coming in to sort this mess out, we're just going to have to do it ourselves. Barbara, get Phil to do a stock take on medication. Jeremy, put the word out for people to congregate at the village hall. It's best we get everyone in one place for the time being.
Good.
I'll organise supplies. We'll have a lot of hungry mouths to feed. There's plenty at the depot, but well, let's start with what's here in the village. I'll draw up a rota. Charlie, you help me with that?
Anything for you, Meg.
I'll head out into the valley and scoop up the isolated families and check in with Lizzie Graves at the camp. Now, has anyone seen or heard anything from Stephen Appleton or his wife?
I couldn't stop it. I couldn't do anything.
Stop. Stop it. Calm down.
Get back. It's in my head.
Howard, wait.
Father. Father, are you all right?
It's my ankle. Oh, Jesus, Lord, I think it's broken. Howard, go and get help.
There's no one left. No one's coming to help us.
Please, Howard, fetch help.
The light. They're in the light. I can see everyone in the light. Oh, God. Oh, my God. Help me.
Meg? Meg, are you here?
Here. I'm in the lounge.
There are too many empty houses tonight. Most of the village is gone now.
My head's killing me. Have you listened to the phones?
No, I thought they were all dead.
There's a strange kind of static now. I think I heard numbers in it. It sounded like the American woman.
Kate, she's still alive. No one's seen her.
Is Charlie back?
Not yet, no. I'm sorry.
That's all right, Father. Listen, you go on ahead. I'll just rest here a little longer.
Sleep well.
I've been recording the pattern for 3 hours, and so far have accumulated over 3 megabytes of binary data. The pattern does not, at this point, seem to be part of any recognizably closed loop, but there remains symmetry, despite the conflicts.
Benjamin, Georgie, leave it alone. It might have fleas.
Hello, Amanda. What are they up to?
Oh, they found another dead bird. I do wish the council would clean them up.
Well, apparently they're saying it's a flu epidemic. And I gather they'll be closing the roads and stations. So they're worried enough for that.
Oh, for goodness sake.
Well, you don't mess about with the flu outbreak, I suppose. But look, I'm just saying, if you were planning on taking the kids to Wales, now might be the time to do it.
Well, thanks, Barbara. I'll have word with Neil, see what he thinks. Now, George, Benjamin, for God's sake, leave it alone!
Meg, come and have a look at this.
Oh, I don't believe it.
Charlie?
Jeremy reckons someone had been raiding all the empty houses. He said a load of stuff had been taken.
What's that?
It looks like someone's been collecting their own supplies.
Bastard.
Well, we've got enough stock in the warehouse to keep the entire village going for months.
We should get a truck.
What, and go and get all of it now?
Yeah, why not?
It's Appleton. It's that bloody crackpot, Stephen Appleton. I'm gonna fucking do him.
Sam, it's fine. We'd better get moving before the weather turns. You come in. We'll swing by the camp and get Rachel on the way back.
It wasn't just some distortion of physics. I may not understand it yet, but it wasn't an accident. All of the clocks, what happened at Tower 6, it's just not random. There's an effort. An attempt to communicate.
you knew.
Wade called me in about 6 weeks after, once he thought I could cope with knowing. Can I ever repay you for what you did?
She was a good woman, Frank.
The best.
You should come back to church. Back to the community. You're missed.
I hate him, Father. I can't get down on my knees and pretend otherwise. And I don't understand why you don't hate him, too.
I try my hardest not to, Frank. It goes against the job description somewhat. Faith is the assurance of things hoped for. The conviction of things not seen. We have to trust him. Even when his methods are hidden from view. Maybe see you on Sunday.
I hung up on Stephen. He doesn't understand. Even if he were here to experience it directly, I'm still not sure he would. There has to be a way of consolidating, of offering reciprocal amplification to this signal.